Hello everybody. Today we shall learn introduction to adjective. What is adjective? Because adjective can be a word, it can be a phrase, it can be a clause. First of all, I would like to tell you that it is not adjective. Here D is silent, it is adjective. Adjective. So this is the real pronunciation. So adjective can be a word, adjective can be a phrase, adjective can be a clause. So what is a phrase, what is a clause? There are some examples given on the board. See, first of all, I go aside. Now you take the screenshot. Okay, now read the first sentence. This is a red pen. Do you know what is a pen? Pen is a noun, and you all know we have got five senses, right? The first one is eyes. Whatever we can see with our eyes is largely noun. Then touch, whatever we can touch with our hands is largely a noun. Then smell, whatever we can smell is largely a noun. I can smell a rose. Then there is a taste, whatever I can taste is largely a noun. For example, I can taste an apple, a banana. They are nouns. Apple is sweet. It is noun. Apple is noun. Sweet is adjective. But apple, I am talking about apple, I am talking about banana. It is a noun. Then ears. We can listen to something. I can listen to a radio. So radio, it is a noun. I can listen to a song. Song is a noun. Then there are some nouns which are abstract also. For example, if I say love, if I say hatred, these are abstract nouns. But this is, see, pen. I can touch a pen. So it is a noun. Now see, this word red modifies a noun. So the word that modifies a noun or pronoun is an adjective. So red is what? Pen is a noun. Pen is what? It is a pen, right? It is a noun. But what is red? Red is adjective. Why? It modifies. It can modify, it modifies a noun. Sometimes it can modify a pronoun also. So noun and pronoun can be modified by adjectives. એવું નથી કે noun જ modify થતું હોય. હવે એક વાક્ય તમે અહીંયા જુઓ. He is honest. અને Rahul is honest. Rahul છે કેવો છે? Honest છે. તો આ honest છે adjective થઈ ગયો. Why? Rahul. Noun. Modifies noun. But instead of noun you can write he. He is a pronoun. Whatever you can write for instead of noun is called pronoun. So now here honest modifies pronoun. So again it is an adjective. Adjectives can be pre-modifier and post-modifier, right? This is a pen. This is a red pen. Now see, pen and red. But if I write the pen here, this pen is red, then this is what? It is post-modifier. એટલે નાઉનની આગળ એ હોઈ શકે. ક્યારેક ક્યારેક નાઉન પોતે આગળ જતું હતું, એડજેક્ટિવ ત્યાં બેઠું રહ્યું, એવું બને આ રહ્યું. Again, it is what? This is also adjective. This is noun. Chalk. Red chalk. Red is what? Adjective. Chalk is what? Noun. You got the idea? Board. Noun. I can touch it. Blackboard. Black is what? Adjective. So, again the second thing I told you, adjective is that something can modify a noun or pronoun. Sometimes it modifies a noun, sometimes it can modify a pronoun also. Then the third thing I told you, adjective can be pre-modifier or post-modifier. Pre-modifier means this is a red pen, now it is red is before a noun, this is pre-modifier. If I write the pen here, this pen is red, this is what? Post-modifier, but it is adjective. આ રેડની પાછળ નાઉન નથી, આ રેડની પાછળ નાઉન બેઠું, આ રેડની પાછળ નાઉન નથી, આ નાયો નહીં આગળ જતું રહ્યું છે. એટલે ઇટ કેન બી એની. હવે રેડ ઇઝ અ સિંગલ વર્ડ ઓનલી, એટલે આ જે છે ને આ ખાલી વર્ડ છે, રાઈટ? અહીં આ રેડ શું છે? ઇટ ઇઝ અ વર્ડ. ઇટ ઇઝ અ વર્ડ. નાઉ વોટ ઇઝ અ ફ્રેઝ? This is a pen of red color. Now see, the pen of red color is a phrase. Phrase, do you know what is a phrase? Phrase is a group of words, but it has no subject verb combination. Ama subject and verb nu combination jo ana mare. Combination keva prakar nu hovo joye? The verb and subject both should be married by tense or any auxiliary. Ama e na hoy. એટલે આ આ જે છે એ ફ્રેઝ ખરું, ગ્રુપ ઓફ વર્ડ્સ ખરું, પણ એ ફ્રેઝ છે કારણ કે આમાં કોઈ સબ્જેક્ટ અને વર્બનું કોમ્બિનેશન નથી, તો આ ફ્રેઝ થઈ ગયું. બટ ધીસ ફ્રેઝ એડ સમથિંગ ટુ ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ અ નાઉન, ધેટ્સ વાય ઇટ ઇઝ એડજેક્ટિવ ફ્રેઝ. સો વોટ ઇઝ એન એડજેક્ટિવ ફ્રેઝ? અ ફ્રેઝ ધેટ એડ્સ સમથિંગ ટુ ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ અ નાઉન. હવે જરાક સાઇડની વાત કરી દો. એડજેક્ટિવ ફ્રેઝ કેન બિગિન ઇન થ્રી વેઝ. ઇટ કેન બિગિન વિથ અ પ્રેપોઝિશન એઝ ઇટ હેઝ બીન ગિવન હિયર, ઓફ ઓફ, એન્ડ અગેન ધેર વિલ બી ઓફ. આ આ બધા અહીંયા ઉદાહરણો અત્યારે મેં પ્રેપોઝિશનવાળા લીધા છે. ઇટ કેન ઓલ્સો બિગિન વિથ અ પાર્ટિસિપલ. And it can also begin with an infinitive. Adjective phrase can begin with a preposition, it can begin with a participle, it can begin with infinitive. Right now, we are dealing with adjective clauses with preposition, right? These two, I will give information in a short while. Now see, this is a group of words. Without subject and verb combination, so it is a phrase. This phrase adds something to the meaning of a noun. This is adjective phrase. Now read this sentence. This is a pen which is red or which is of red color. Now see, your concentration should be here, which is red or which is of red color. This is group of words, this is a group of words, but here this group of words has subject verb combination. This is subject, this is verb, this is subject, this is verb. If the subject verb combination is found, then it is not a phrase, it is a clause. This clause adds something to the meaning of a noun. This is a pen which is red. Which is red what? Pen. So, which is red adds something to the meaning of a noun. Whatever adds to the meaning of a noun is called adjective. Here it is a clause. It is adjective clause. Whatever adds to the meaning of a noun is adjective. It is what? Phrase. So this is adjective phrase. What is an adjective? Adjective adds something to the meaning of a noun or a pronoun. Second thing, what is adjective phrase? A phrase that modifies a noun or pronoun, or a phrase that adds something to the meaning of a noun. What is adjective clause? A clause that modifies a noun or a pronoun, or simply, let me tell you, a clause that adds something to the meaning of a noun is called adjective clause. Now this is second set. Rina is a beautiful girl. Now see, as you know, girl is what? A noun, right? And this term beautiful adds to the meaning of a noun. आ जे शब्द है ब्यूटिफुल ए गर्ल ना अर्थ में वधारो करे छे. गर्ल केवी गर्ल? ब्यूटिफुल गर्ल. अहीं शुं हतुं? पेन. केवी पेन? लाल पेन. तो आ ब्यूटिफुल छे ए पेन आ गर्ल ना अर्थ में वधारो करे छे. हवे आ गर्ल जे छे इट इज अ नाउन, सो दिस वन एड्स ओर मॉडिफाइज नाउन, सो दिस इज एडजेक्टिव. आ वर्ड छे. हवे आ जुओ, रीना इज अ गर्ल ऑफ ग्रेट ब्यूटी. Again, a girl is what? It is a noun. Of great beauty. It begins with a preposition. Of great beauty. खूब सुंदरता वाली है. कौन? रीना. એટલે એ રીનાના અર્થમાં અથવા તો ગર્લ બે એક જ છે. રીના લ્યો કે ગર્લ લ્યો, રાઈટ? રીના કે ગર્લના અર્થમાં વધારો કરે છે. આ આ આ તો પેલું કોમ્પ્લિમેન્ટ છે. રીનાના અર્થમાં કહ્યું કે ગર્લના અર્થમાં કહ્યું. બોથ આર નાઉન. દિસ ઇઝ પ્રોપર નાઉન. દિસ ઇઝ કોમન નાઉન, રાઈટ? So this is what? A great beauty. It adds something to the meaning of a noun, so this is adjective. But here it is a phrase. It is a group of words. But there is no subject and verb combination. Finite verb is not found, so this is an adjective phrase. Have you got the idea? Now see, Rina is a girl who is beautiful or who is of great beauty. Now see here, who is beautiful? Who is beautiful? Add something to the meaning of a girl or a, or this word, Rina. This is noun, so this is going to be adjective. Why? Because it adds something to the meaning of a noun. But here it is what? It is a group of words, but there is subject combination is found. This is subject, this is verb. So this is a clause, adjective clause. Why it is adjective? Because it adds something to the meaning of a noun, and whatever adds something to the meaning of a noun is called adjective. But here it is a clause. It is adjective clause. This is single word, this is phrase, this is clause. Single word, phrase, clause, whatever it is, it adds something to the meaning of a noun. Girl or Rina. Third set. એટલે એવું ના હોય કે adjective કે adjective clause બધું વાક્યના પાછળના ભાગમાં જ આવે. ઇટ કેન સીટ ઇન ધ બિગિનિંગ ઓલ્સો, ઇટ ઇઝ ધ પ્લેસ ઓફ સબ્જેક્ટ ઓલ્સો સમટાઈમ્સ. અ વોચ ઇઝ ઓન ધ ટેબલ. નાઉ દિસ ઇઝ વોટ? વોચ ઇઝ અ નાઉન. નાઉ ઇફ આઈ રાઇટ અ કોસ્ટલી વોચ ઇઝ ઓન ધ ટેબલ. નાઉ સી, દિસ વર્ડ કોસ્ટલી, it adds something to the meaning of a noun. So this is going to be adjective. It is a single word only, right? Now if I write a very costly watch is on the table. Now there are two words. Very costly watch is on the table. Two words. Adjective phrase. A watch of great cost is on the table. Of great cost is on the table. Phrase. A watch which is costly or which is very costly or which is of great cost is on the table. Close. Why? Single word. There was no adjective. A watch is on the table. There is no adjective, right? But if I write a costly watch, now this word costly adds something to the meaning of a noun. Whatever adds something to the meaning of a noun is called adjective. Highly costly watch. Now this highly and costly both add to the meaning of a noun. Both are adjective, but since there are two words, adjective, phrase, there is no combination of subject and finite verb. A watch of great cost. Now, did you find the difference? If I put the noun before adjective phrase, then adjective phrase will start with preposition. It can start with preposition, participle or infinitive, right? અહીંયા નથી શરૂ થયું, શું કામ? અહીંયા વોચ જે છે એ તો પાછળ છે, એટલે આ પ્રી મોડિફાયર છે. પોસ્ટ મોડિફાયર થશે એટલે આ આ ફ્રેશથી ત્રણ રીતે શરૂ થાય, પ્રેપોઝિશન, પાર્ટિસિપલ અથવા તો ઇન્ફિનિટિવથી. અ વોચ ઓફ ગ્રેટ કોસ્ટ ઇઝ ઓન ધ ટેબલ. હવે આ પણ શું છે? અ વોચ ઓફ ગ્રેટ કોસ્ટ, ઇટ ઇઝ અ ફ્રેઝ, એડ સમથિંગ ટુ ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ અ નાઉન. અજેક્ટિવ ફ્રેઝ, અજેક્ટિવ ફ્રેઝ, અજેક્ટિવ સિંગલ વર્ડ. અ વોચ વિચ ઇઝ કોસ્ટલી, સબ્જેક્ટ વર્બ કોમ્બિનેશન ઇઝ ફાઉન્ડ, ઇટ ઇઝ અ ક્લોઝ. આ તો ક્લોઝ છે, અને એ કોના અર્થમાં વધારો કરે છે? નાઉનના અર્થમાં. વોચ ઇઝ અ નાઉન, સો વોટ એવર એડ સમથિંગ ટુ ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ અ નાઉન ઇઝ અજેક્ટિવ. ધીસ ઇઝ અજેક્ટિવ ક્લોઝ. એટલે તમે આને વિચ ઇઝ કોસ્ટલી લખો, વિચ ઇઝ વેરી કોસ્ટલી લખો, કે વિચ ઇઝ ઓફ ગ્રેટ કોસ્ટ, આ બધું ક્લોઝ થઈ ગયું. એટલે આ પણ ક્લોઝ છે. વિચ ઇઝ લખવાનો છે, which is costly or which is very costly or which is of great cost is on the table. So, આ બધું adjective clause થઈ ગયું. ઓકે, now I will give you the examples of the sentences which begin with participle and infinitive. Okay, now you do one thing, take the screenshot and it will be very useful for you to take note, or you are making a note, it will be very helpful there. Now see, first of all take the screenshot. There are four sets of sentences. The first two, which is of yellow and blue, are having adjective phrases beginning with participle. This is present participle, this is past participle. And this light green and this brown color, these two sets, they have the adjective clauses which begin with infinitive, right? Now let's learn how it is. The boy is Rahul. Here we don't have any kind of adjective, right? The boy and Rahul both are complement to each other. This is a common noun and this is proper noun. The boy is Rahul. But if I write the boy reading a book is Rahul, right? Now see, reading a book, it is a group of words. There is no subject verb combination. Definitely this is a verb, but it is not joined to the subject by tense or any auxiliary. The boy reading, there is no tense like that. If it is the boy is reading, the boy was reading, will be reading, has been reading, then it is okay. But this is not subject verb combination. So reading is not a finite verb, though it appears like a verb, it is not a finite verb. Reading a book, book vachto chokro, vachto chokro, kon vachto chhe, chokro chhe. So these three words, reading, a and book, this is a phrase. This phrase adds something to the meaning of a noun, that's why this is adjective phrase. Is it clear to you? The phrase that adds something to the meaning of a noun is called adjective phrase. And why this is phrase? Because it is no subject verb combination. Now, the same sentence if I write like this, a boy who is reading a book is Rahul. Then see what is happening here. Who is reading a book? Now see, chokro, કે જે બુક વાંચી રહ્યો છે એ રાહુલ છે. કે જે બુક વાંચી રહ્યો છે કોણ છે? એ છોકરો છે. હુ ઇઝ રીડિંગ અ બુક, ધીસ ઇઝ અ ગ્રુપ ઓફ વર્ડ્સ, ઇટ એડ સમથિંગ ટુ ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ અ નાઉન. સો ડેફિનેટલી ઇટ ઇઝ, ધીસ ગ્રુપ ઓફ વર્ડ્સ ઇઝ ગોઈંગ ટુ બી અજેક્ટિવ. ઓકે, બટ સી, ધીસ ઇઝ સબ્જેક્ટ ફાઇનાઇટ વર્બ. સબ્જેક્ટ વર્બ કોમ્બિનેશન ઇઝ ફાઉન્ડ દેર. ધીસ ઇઝ સબ્જેક્ટ, ધીસ ઇઝ ફાઇનાઇટ વર્બ. હુ આર રીડિંગ, હુ ઇઝ રીડિંગ, So this is finite one. So it is a clause. So this clause is adjective clause. Why this is adjective clause? Because this clause adds something to the meaning of a noun, that is boy. The boy who is reading a book is Rahul. This phrase, here it has begun with present participle. Participles are of three types. Did you hear it? Participles are of three types. The first one is present participle. And you know it. Going, coming, taking, eating, seeing, watching. These are all present participle. Then comes past participle. Go becomes gone. Come becomes come. Take becomes taken. These are past participles. And then comes perfect participle. Then perfect participles are taking having with it. Having gone. If it is take, having taken, having seen, having eaten, having written, having read, having visited, these are all perfect participles, right? So here it was present participle, and see, it is past participle here. The shop situated in Motibagh is huge. Now see, the shop is huge. Now see, this is noun. Huge is what? It is adjective. Add something to the meaning of a noun, shop. But now read this sentence. The shop situated in Motibagh is huge. Now this word, situated in Motibagh. In Motibagh means Motibagh area. The shop situated in Motibagh area is huge. Now situated in Motibagh area, what is situated? The shop, still situated in Motibagh, it adds something to the meaning of a noun. So this is going to be adjective, right? It is adjective, whatsoever it is. Certainly it is not a single word, because single word is here. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four words, Motibagh. These four words is a group of words, but subject finite verbs are not found. So this is called phrase. Adjective phrase. Now, the shop which is situated in Motibagh is used. Now, which is situated in Motibagh. See, this is a clause, because subject is found, finite verb is found. Which is situated in Motibagh. Ke je Motibagh ma aveli che, shu ke je shop. So it is going to be adjective, whatever it is, whether it is a clause or phrase, it is going to be adjective. Why? Because it adds something to the meaning of a noun. But it is a clause because there is subject finite verb combination is found. So this is called adjective clause. This clause adds something to the meaning of a noun. I don't have a friend to trust blindly. Suppose I write, I don't have a friend. I write the sentence like this only. Then a friend is a noun. But I extend the sentence, I don't have a friend to trust blindly. A to trust blindly je che ne, e kona arth ma vadharo kare che, friend na arth ma vadharo kare che. Aje se to trust blindly. Now see, it begins with an infinitive. A badu infinitive thi shuru thyu. A me participle thi shuru karyu. I told you adjective phrase can begin with preposition also. It can begin with participle. It can begin with infinitive. To trust blindly. એવું હોય કે મારી પાસે મિત્ર નથી કે જેનો હું બ્લાઇન્ડલી ભરોસો કરી શકું. કોનો ભરોસો કરવાનો છે? મિત્રનો કરવાનો છે. સો વોટ એવર ધીસ ઇઝ, ઇટ ઇઝ એડજેક્ટિવ. નાઉ ધીસ ઇઝ નોટ અ સિંગલ વર્ડ. 1, 2, 3, દેર આર થ્રી વર્ડ્સ. ઇટ ઇઝ અ ફ્રેઝ, રાઇટ? વાય ફ્રેઝ? બિકોઝ દેર ઇઝ નો સબ્જેક્ટ. વિધાઉટ સબ્જેક્ટ ઇટ કેન નોટ બી અ ક્લોઝ. ઇટ ઇઝ અ ફ્રેઝ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ એડજેક્ટિવ ફ્રેઝ. And this adjective phrase has started with infinitive. But if I write the same sentence like this, I don't have a friend whom I can trust blindly. Whom I can trust blindly. Akon arthma vadharo kare che, friend na arthma. Friend is a noun. Whatever it is that adds something or modifies a noun is called adjective, right? So this is going to be adjective, but it is a clause here. Why? I can trust. Subject verb combination is found. So this is called adjective clause. This clause adds something to the meaning of a noun. She is the girl. If I write the sentence, then this girl is noun. If I extend it, she is the girl to be selected for the company. A company ma select thava vaadi a chokri chhe. Now to be selected for the company begins with infinitive. Add something to the meaning of a noun. Company માટે select thanari kon? Chokri. The company માટે select thanari a girl na athma vardharo kahe. So whatever it is adjective. Whether it is a phrase or a clause. Now let's check. It is a phrase. Why? Because subject is not found there. So this is called adjective phrase. This is adjective phrase. She is the girl who can be selected for the company. The same sentence can be written like this also. Now this is a girl who can be selected for the company, since it is having subject and finite verb. It is a clause and adds something to the meaning of a noun. So this is adjective clause. Adjective is a single word that modifies noun or pronoun, adds something to the meaning of a noun or pronoun. Phrase is a group of words which has no subject verb combination. Clause is a group of words which is a part of a sentence, almost like a sentence having one subject, one predicate, that is one subject, one finite verb. There is one subject, one finite verb means there is subject and verb combination by tense or any auxiliary is a clause. Adjective phrase, phrase that adds something to the meaning of a noun. Adjective clause, clause that adds something to the meaning of a noun. Here we end, but I would like to tell you, still one more video is there for introduction of adjective clause only. Some more examples have been given. But I want you to think something. What is adjective? How can it begin? What are the two types? What is pre-modifier, post-modifier? Think it. And I want you to be very attentive. See, check any adjective clause. Who is reading a book? It is after a noun, which is situated in Motibagh, which is also after a noun. So noun and then comes clause. There is a noun, then comes clause. Here is also a noun and then comes clause. Here is also a noun, then comes clause. So adjective clause, you know, adjective clause. If you see the pattern of a sentence, it is always followed by a noun. If there is a clause which occurs after a noun, then this clause is adjective clause. So what is the situation in a sentence? Noun plus adjective clause. This thing is very important to identify the type of a sentence, that is simple, compound, complex. And if it is complex, what is it? Noun clause or adjective clause? How will you identify it? It is like this. Adjective clause always follows noun. Now, this is in the next lecture. Now, you do one thing. Take the screenshot and prepare your notebook on your own.